Hi, in this video, I'm going to demonstrate how I use SHARE C1 LiDAR scanner for scanning this job site. It's a restaurant and the architect firm, my customer, they want to turn this place into a burger restaurant. So they are going to renovate this place. So the architect will start a new design by using the scan data from this LiDAR scanner as a reference. The time before the LiDAR scanner, the architect would come to the job site themselves using a measuring tape and photograph everything, and then they will compare it with the blueprint if they can find one, but they never know the actual change and modification that the owner made to this job site. You can notice that there are large mirror inside of the toilet, and the mirror can create reflection of the point cloud on the opposite side of the wall. And sometimes when you are going to scan a very small room like this, you have to sit down to capture the floor area, because if you stand about this height, there's going to be a blind spot about 2.8 meters in front of you on the floor. I'm trying to walk in zigzag patterns, capturing all sides of the wall, and the closer you are to the object, the higher detail is going to capture. The architect also wants to capture the position of the trees and vegetation for integrating into their design. And trees are very difficult to measure using the other measuring tools. So the LiDAR scanner performed the best for this kind of job. Okay, when you walk out in an open area like this without the RTK, it's going to drift on the Z-axis. But all this error can be corrected using the SLAM algorithm. And you can use this data for capturing the floor level. Okay, I missed one of the room here. It looked like a storage room. Guess the staff just opened the door and I didn't notice it. Switching between outdoor and indoor, vice versa, there will be an issue with the SHARE C1. I've tried over 30-40 scans and it never fell. You can notice that the preview screen is very fast and responsive, so it moves when I move. There is no lagging and I never found it lost the track, not even once since I start using it. And the phones that I'm using is about 3-4 years old, not the fastest phone. All the processing is done inside the scanner. It only uses your phone for streaming the picture, and from my experience, your phone's battery will die before the scanner battery. I really don't see the reason why you need a second battery, because you need to stop for charging your phones anyway. Now I'm going to sit down and capture the stairs. Okay, now I'm returning to the starting point to close the loop. Over 400 meters of the trajectory and 14 minutes of the scanning time. After you finish your scan, you can preview the scan data before you place the back button on the upper left corner. And once you stop the scan, you cannot recontinue the scan. 4 hours driving here back and forth, for 14 minutes of the scan work. This software, you don't have to log in to use it. The basic function, point cloud mapping and point cloud viewing function. So you can just skip the login. This will be the data calculation. Okay, this will be the parameter tab. Now I know what this function is do. This torsion remove photo output. If you turn this on, you have an undistort folder. You can use this for training 3D Gaussian splatting. Okay, this will be the result from the scan. The performance when you are viewing is very good because it has its proprietary point cloud format. It will create a new file that used for viewing in this software. It's a bin file. And the performance is very good. I really like their preview software. And the first person, You don't have this with the CloudCompare. I forgot to mention that the processing time for this almost 2 hours. Okay, this will be the interior. Go and do measurement. Click on here. Click on here. And click on floor. Yeah. 3.42 meters. 3.39. Okay, after this, I'm going to bring the result into CloudCompare for the alignment because Share Studio, they don't have a point cloud alignment function. You can do a clipping function. When you clip it, okay, like this, you get to see the floor plan. But when you clip it and you save it, it's going to create another set of the point clouds. You will fill up your storage space very, very quickly. So I recommend that if you want to do a cross section and point cloud alignment, you should do this in the CloudCompare. So the first time you start your scan, it's going to use that floor as a reference for the XY plane, and it's not level. This is the part of my head. When you hold this 3D scanner, you should hold at your shin level. If you hold it too low, it's going to scan some part of your head. This is a very good scan data that you put on the screen in the meeting room. When I went into the toilet, there's a large mirror going to refract. This is a reflection from the mirror to the opposite side. So this room is not real. I can't even read this. The wall line is very thin. Yeah, it's less than 1 centimeter for sure. You can see part of the furniture. I walk behind the counter and I walk out this. With this scanner, I also noticed that the sharp corner will appear round. You need to inspect using the color of the scan. If you look at the color, you can measure the width of the column using the color, but you can't do this with the cross-section profiles. It's going to appear round. This column is bigger. It appears to be a square. I have a complete stare because I sit down. I think I sit down here. This will be the rest floor. They extend the balcony. I don't think it's legal. I know it's not my job. I just scan it. Okay, let's take a look at the trees. Okay, the designer, the architect can use the tree lines. The covering of the tree is also important. They need to design it for a seating area. I think it looks very good. Non-color version is 100 million points, but I don't think anyone will use it. When the designer wants to make a restaurant, they need to make a sign and they need a perspective view to see where they can put the sign on. So if a driver driving to this direction, they should spot the sign long before the restaurant, right? So they can turn. This is the parking area, so they can turn into the restaurant. But from this perspective, there is no place to put a sign. Maybe this food stall has to go. I think it's a good place to put up a sign here. The vegetation is very dense. It's good for sitting area, but it's covered the front. Okay, this is CloudCompare, a freeware that is very useful for 3D scanning. Drag and drop the LAS files in here. Okay, next I'm going to crop the data. The viewport performance from the CloudCompare is not as good as the SHARE Studio. There's a crop tool here, look like a scissors. Need to click on the point cloud, click on the crop tool. This is the selection tools. I'm gonna use the polygonal. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. A little bit of the toilet. And click on here to crop it. And click on the delete key here. With CloudCompare, it's not going to create a new set of the point cloud data. Next, I'm going to align this. Click on here, these tools, and click on the Z-axis. Look at here, this is the Z-axis. Click on top view first, and choose the Z-axis to rotate it like this. Zoom in, and I use the floor for reference. Click on check mark. Okay, next, I'm going to crop this tools, and I'm going to move it down until I start to reveal the columns. Okay, now the column is revealed. Click on here. It will create another set of the scan data. You know, you can close it. Now you have two of them. If I turn this off, this will be the original data. And this one will be the crop data. So I'm going to use the crop data for alignment because the ceiling is gone. Click on both of the scan because you are going to turn these two scan together. You need to click on both, hold the control key. Click on these tools. And now we're gonna do a refinement, adjusting to the XY axis. Okay, let me, I think this one is already good, but you can move it. So these two scan is going to move together, but you see only one scan. Click on check mark. You can't delete this one because we need to use it for temporary. Next, I'm going to align the floor along the X axis. So I need to crop it, just slice it. Like this, make it a little bit thinner, like this. Okay, this will be the ceiling, right? And this will be the floor. I need to align it to the bottom of my mirror. This floor is already level, so I don't need to do adjustment. What about the ceiling? Yeah, the ceiling is fairly level. Let's try the X axis. Click on here, gonna slide it so that I can see the X axis. Click on this check mark, right? Click on rotation. You're going to rotate it along the Y axis and align it to the edge of your mirror. Line is the line. Either you draw it in CAD or using the edge of your mirror. It's a line. Doesn't matter. Okay, next I'm going to save it. Click on this as the LAS file format. Okay, this is AutoCAD recap. If you want to export your point cloud data to work with the AutoCAD, Revit, AutoCAD Inventor, or any other AutoCAD product, you need to convert your point cloud into RCP file format. I will use the window selection tools to select the top part of the scan data, and then I'm going to click on new region. After that, my scan will have two layers, so that I can turn off with just one click. So it's quicker than doing the cropping. So you can do as many layers as you like. Okay, this is AutoCAD. Click on insert. Click on attach. Then you're gonna see the RCP files that you made using the recap. Click on open. You don't have to scale it. It's the LiDAR scan data. Okay, I need to create a column center line. 400 by 400. This will be a center line. I'm gonna draw a new 370 by 400. Okay, this should go all the way to the other side, so this will be another column, and it look aligned from here to here. See, it's about 4 meter. They hide another column inside this wall. I'm gonna offset it to 4000. Okay, this will be the column span. Make another vertical line. Go up to here. Ah, okay, it's match. Go all the way down here. 4.5. Ah, it's match. So this one will be 4.5 as well. Let's check the wall thickness. It should be 5 centimeter. Yeah, 57, perfect. So the wall in Thailand, usually the thickness is 10 centimeters, include the lengthening. They have another columns here. I think the column size 200 by 200. This will be the structural columns. This one too, yeah. It's look round, the column that scanned from the chassis one. But you look here, it's rectangle. It's rectangle columns. This will be one more here, one more here, one more here, one more here. And this will be only the decorative circle. It's quite accurate, as you can see. Nothing unusual. You can use it for tracing the line of the floor. Okay, this will be the final drawing that I made for the architect. When you click on the point cloud, you have many tools. You can change the point size and you can crop it using these tools. Like that crops, you can crop and try data. See here, same as in the cloud compare. You can crop it for making a cross section drawing. When you click on here, you can turn on and off the part that you separate a layer with a recap. Now the ceiling is gone with just one click. Now it's come back. Now it's gone. So it's faster if you do a separate layer using recap. It's not my main job. I design the tensile structures and I know many architects, and sometimes they hire me to do a job site survey using the LiDAR scanner. Okay, so here's my workflow from 3D scan to making a complete floor plan for the customer. Thanks you guys for watching. I'll see you in the next video.